Good morning all. Today we are going to see a topic called structure in C programming. So everybody knows what is array. So array is nothing but it is a collection of similar data types. So for example, you can collect the integer data type of D alone or char alone. So array is like it collects only the similar data types. Whereas if you want to collect the details of the student, suppose he has a roll number, he has a name, and then he has marks, which is in float, then we cannot store that in array. So for that purpose, we go for the structure, where structure is a collection of variables of different data types under a single name. Okay. So the data type of this structure will be the struct. We'll see that. So the variables of these structures are called members of the structure. So, and this structure is called a user defined data type. So the structure is called as a user defined data type. So defining a structure, let's see how the structure will be defined. So the struct name, so you have to give a name for the structure. It can be of anything, it can be any name. So struct is a keyword that you are supposed to give, and then struct name is a keyword. Okay, sorry, struct name is a name that you can give. It struct is a keyword, and this structure, this is also called structure tag, that is an optional. So there is no any mandatory that you have to give a structure tag or a structure name. Okay, but struct keyword is mandatory. So you have to open the curly braces, you have to close the curly braces with a semicolon. Semicolon is very important. So between these curly braces, so you have to initialize your structure members. So what will be the structure members? For example, struct student, this structure name is student, then the member variables would be int roll number, and then char name, and then float marks. So that could act as a structure members. Okay, so the variables for the structure is supposed to be created, because through this variable only we can access the structure members. So once the structure members are created, the memory for this structure is actually not allocated. That is just a template. So this part is just a template. No memory will be actually created. Once you create the structure variable, the memory will be allocated for the particular structure. So how you will be creating the structure variable? Struct, structure name. So whatever you are giving, struct, structure name. And if you are not going to give the structure name, so you need not give it here. I told you already, there's an option, struct, structure name, and then the variable you are going to give. Okay, for example, if you are going to give struct student, then struct student s1 semicolon could be the structure variable. So I would like to show an example. Struct student char name, so name will be having some 20 characters, right? So 20. So int roll number, float marks, char gender, long int phone number. So you're closing the curly braces with a semicolon. So struct student, whatever you are given here, you are giving as such, and you're creating it with a variable st with a semicolon. Okay, so see here, you can also give multiple variables for a same structure. Suppose in case if you want to go for some 10 students, then you can give like st1, st2, st3. So with this, I've told you how to create a structure with the member variables and then with the structure members. So we'll see the elaborate topics in the next session. Thank you.